Hey guys, Ms. Sherard here again. Just wanted to do a real quick tutorial on our new vital sign patient monitors. You may encounter this anytime during your simulations or practice time here at Temple College, but this is also useful information for when you're out at the clinical sites. Just please keep in mind that these values may change in color and positioning depending on your patient monitor. Let's get started. Right here, we have HR, that stands for your heart rate. SpO2, that's your pulse ox. So that is coming from the pulse oximeter that you either have on someone's finger or the ear, but that extra tool that you use to get the pulse ox. Next to that, on this monitor, we're showing pulse. When you see the pulse, that is the pulse that is being read from your pulse oximeter. So most pulse oximeters read the oxygen in the blood as well as the pulse rate. Please do not be concerned if the pulse and the heart rate are not perfectly in sync, because remember, these are coming from different locations. The heart rate is coming from your EKG leads, whereas the pulse from the pulse oximeter is being read from wherever that device is currently placed. Next, we have ABP, that is your arterial blood pressure. Down here, we have NIBP, that is non-invasive blood pressure. So that's a blood pressure cuff versus an arterial line, which would be a small catheter placed in an artery. On our monitors, we can start and stop our blood pressures, and it'll read as a regular vital signs monitor would. Over here, we have ETCO2, that is your end tidal CO2, and then we have AWRR, that is your airway respiratory rate, otherwise known as the respiratory rate of the patient. How often are they breathing? So like I said, these may change depending on the monitor that you're looking at. The colors may change, the placement of the vitals may change, but overall, that is a real quick get to know your vital signs monitor. Thanks.